Hey guys, it's me again, and I've thought about doing this for a while, and I figured that, you know what, today is the day we're going to do it. Today I want to show you guys what I do. This is just an average day for me. I want to take you guys through a day in the life of Asmongold. It's just what I usually do throughout the day and how I usually do it. So anyway, I'm going to kind of record myself throughout the day and put it all together and make a video out of it. To start off, obviously, I'm in bed here. I just woke up about an hour ago, and I usually have my morning routine of laying in bed and then reading Twitter, and then I'll get bored of reading Twitter and I'll watch YouTube videos, and then after I get bored of watching YouTube videos, I'll go back to Twitter, and then after I go back to Twitter and I get bored of Twitter, I'll go to like maybe Reddit or maybe Instagram, and I'll look at those for maybe a little bit. And then I'll go back over to YouTube, and then I'll go to Twitter. And this process usually lasts for about an hour. And so that's what I've been doing for about an hour now. And I'm in the middle of watching a video about something I don't care about. And so it's about 10 minutes. I'm gonna have to pause this video here and recording to finish it to make sure that I figure out what happens at the end of it. But then after that, usually what I'll do is I'll lay in bed for a little bit longer and plan out what fast food restaurant I want to go to. And then after that, I'll maybe spend 20 more minutes laying in bed, fantasizing about imaginary situations that will never happen. And so we're going to go ahead and I'm going to cut the video here and we're going to move on ahead to the next step. So stay tuned. All right. Well, at this point, seen pretty much every video on YouTube. I've read every tweet on Twitter. And so now I have no choice but to get up and join the real world. It's very disappointing, but here we are. So now, it's pretty much the hardest part of my day. I'm going to decide whether I want to go to Wendy's or Sonic for breakfast. I'm kind of feeling Wendy's. It'd be good. I haven't been to Wendy's in like a week. So I probably should go there. But I might go to Sonic too. It's just a pretty hard decision to make. I'll probably think about it for another 10 minutes or so. And then I'll just get in the car. Get in the car and make a decision while I'm driving over to one or the other. Well, it's probably about time to get up. Alright. So. Oh. Well, all right, I'll see if my mom's awake. I'm sure she's gonna really appreciate me doing these videos.
All right, guys. Well, I just had to announce to my mom that I was making a video, and she is shaking her head. She put her hand on her face. She's very annoyed, and she doesn't know that she's not even being recorded. I'm just talking to the camera without looking at her at all. And I just want to start off first thing of the day here is I want to have my first breakfast. And we're going to get one of these here. There we go. We've got ourselves a Reese's peanut butter treat. And now the next thing that I usually do, this is in my house here, is we go and we feed the birds. Do you think they deserve to be fed today? She says yes. She's like, yes, they do deserve to be fed. So we'll go ahead and we'll do that. Give me one second. Well, boys, it's time for us to feed the old birds. So here's the bird area. This is pretty much where we feed the birds here. And go ahead and just set this down just for a second. And you guys will take a look and see kind of what's going on here. Give me a second. I'll just set this down. Sorry about this, guys. I gotta pour it all out. There we go. So, you know, like in WoW, how they have like a random events, and like, you know, sometimes a rare spawn happens? Well, it turns out we have a rare spawn today in my house. The refrigerator broke. How about that? Isn't that great? So, I'm gonna have to go to Home Depot and buy and order a new refrigerator today. A little excitement. And, gonna go ahead and do that before we probably head on over to Wendy's. So we've got the bird food right here. There it is. Birds are very happy. And as soon as I leave, they'll go ahead and they'll come back over and start doing bird things. So let's go ahead, we'll go over to Home Depot, boys. Fuck. Well, it's time for us to go over to Home Depot. Gotta get ourselves a new fucking refrigerator. It took me a couple of starts for the car, so looks like pretty soon we're probably gonna have to go buy a new car too. Anyway, got my car here. It's my 2001 Mustang. It's absolutely beautiful, amazing car. I love it. I've had it for a long time. And now we're gonna drive on over there and we're gonna make this happen. Where the hell are my keys? Oh, they're in the car. Anyway, so generally, boys, like I usually have never bought a refrigerator before, but the way I look at it is that, like, here's how I see a refrigerator, okay? Who doesn't have a refrigerator? If everybody has a refrigerator, it's probably, I gotta make sure you can't see where I'm at. If everybody got a refrigerator, it's probably not that hard to figure it out. So my mom's got a bunch of different fucking things that she don't want to have in the refrigerator. She doesn't want the refrigerator to, as she called it, phone home. And that means that she don't want a refrigerator that can go to the internet. I went over to S-Fan's old house with Professor Akali and McGlacier back in the day. And they had bought an $8,000 refrigerator that could tweet for some reason. And I had a little board we could draw on it. Drew a dick on the board, and it was there for like months, and so it's really good use of $8,000. Jesus Christ, really good use of $8,000. Anyway, so we're gonna be going over to Home Depot, looking at some refrigerators, and I'm just gonna buy one of these motherfuckers. Like, so the thing with the refrigerator that we have now, I'm gonna be honest, boys, we've had that refrigerator during the struggle days. Like, I remember I bought that fucking refrigerator. Somebody did me a favor selling me that refrigerator for $50. $50 for a working refrigerator for 10 years? That's pretty goddamn good. So we're gonna go on over to Home Depot and probably spend, I don't know how much money I want. I don't wanna spend a lot of money on a fucking refrigerator. She's got like eight different things and she shut the fuck up. Anyway, I've got to make sure it's not an LG. I got to make sure it's not a. Let me make sure this is good. I'm gonna stop right here. There we go. Yeah. So anyway, I've got to make sure that it doesn't have a fucking internet connection to it. I've got to make sure it's not Samsung or LG. I've got to make sure that it's fucking three, like five, 5'10", like 5'11" or shorter. Like 2.5 fucking. I forgot the dimensions. Hey, welcome, dude. I'm just kidding. It's 3 feet across and 2 feet deep, 2.5 feet deep. So I gotta go buy this motherfucker. Now, I've thought about getting a new refrigerator for a while. I hope that I can get a bigger one, but she's probably gonna mold out if I do that. I told her I could fucking help her renovate the kitchen, because I'm gonna be honest, like, our kitchen, like, there are crackheads that would not be, they would not even cook a crack rock in my kitchen. That's how disgusting it is. It's not good. It's actually so bad. There's like the bottom of like all the cupboards and everything is like rotted out, and there are like rats that would like they'd come out of the holes and they'd like terrorize us. Terrorize my mom. I don't really give a shit about them, right? So anyway, traffic. So yeah, so I took like this putty thing, or this like foam that was like in a can, and I spray it, and it covers all of it. I did that recently, so the rats can't get through anymore. And, you know, I didn't really give a shit about the rats too much, but my mom really wasn't a fan, so we had to do something about it. And then sometimes they'll die in like somewhere, and you don't know where they are, and it just smells really bad. So it's better to not have rats than to have them. I don't even have a good sense of smell, and then they still fuck with me. So anyway,
that's pretty much where I'm at. That's what I'm doing. That's where I'm going. Shit! Red light. I was trying to, you know, it's always a mistake to follow traffic rules. Fuck. I'd already be a lot closer if I wasn't, but, you know, it is what it is. Anyway, so, what I'm gonna go ahead and do is, I'll see you guys over at Home Depot. Be back in like 10 minutes or so.
Well, they sold out of the first one that I'm trying to get, so now we're going for number two. Sending text messages to my mom, making sure that she's getting the one that she wants. And I'm gonna tell you guys something, boys. I think I deserve some Wendy's after this bullshit.
Well, finally got over to Wendy's. Holy fuck ass, dude. Two refrigerators that I was going to buy, they didn't have. Can you believe that? I'm mad, but we got one. We got it ordered. It's showing up probably like next week or some shit. I am going to get something special today. Hi, can I get a number one with just ketchup and mustard and cheese on the burger? Large.
And number one with only ketchup and cheese?
Ketchup, mustard, and cheese.
Large for the combo?
Yes, please.
For the drink?
A large Dr. Pepper with light ice.
Light ice?
Yeah.
Anything else?
Ed, could I also get a 6-piece spicy chicken nuggets?
What kind of dipping sauce?
No dipping sauce.
Anything else?
That's all.
Thank you.
I haven't gotten a Dave single for like 10 years. I used to always get them whenever my dad would take me to Wendy's because he was paying for that shit, you know? But ever since I started to have to pay for that, I'm like, man, $4 for a hamburger. Yeah, right. Somebody told me that they taste better, though. Like, it's a different meat or some shit. So I figured I would try it out and just see what it's like because it's been such a long time. I kind of forgot what it really tastes like, to be honest with you. But it's about 5 p.m. now, and I spent over an hour at Home Depot trying to think about refrigerators. Usually that's about an hour more than I usually ever spend thinking about the refrigerator. So this is a bit much for me. I had to go outside. Basically, I mean, I'll be honest, having to not be on the computer for an hour pretty much ruined my whole day. It really sucks. But hopefully we'll be able to get back home and get back to playing video games. And the day won't be completely ruined. Well, we'll see what happens. I was gonna get a pizza later, but it's too late for that now. I never like getting shit delivered. Thank you. No, I'll be all right. Thank you. You too. Okay, here we go. Usually I get chili. Today I didn't get chili though. I don't like how they have the white beans in the chili, man. White beans look fucking disgusting. It's like, I want to eat a white bean, like the brown kidney beans, like the dark brown like kidney beans. They look good, you know, like it's like there's a certain point of like, especially with like fast food, man, you don't want to eat something that looks like shit. And a white little, a white bean, it's like, I thought the first time somebody, I saw it, somebody slipped a,
do you
hi.
Have a large single cheeseburger combo?
Yeah. Thank you. Right. So yeah, I'm not happy about the chili change. They changed the color of the beans. It's fucking weird. But you know, it is what it is, I guess. I don't like this pasta over here. Alright. We're good. That's good shit. That's the old good shit. So we'll go ahead, we'll get some, I have a plan, I have it like calibrated for where I can eat everything on the way home. So, anyway, all's well that ends well. At the end of the day, we got the fucking refrigerator. And that is a good thing, because we didn't have it, really nothing would change for me. I never get anything out of the refrigerator. I usually just eat canned food. or fast food. But excuse me, my mom's gonna be pissed for this next week. Now I gotta go back home, and I'm gonna go and throw away everything in the old refrigerator. That's gonna take me a while. So probably like, I don't know, maybe an hour or so. Throw all that shit in the garbage, and then yeah, I finally get to get on the computer. Looking forward to it. I'll see you there.
We made it, boys. We made it back to the old computer. Thank God for that. Well, anyway, now it's about, let's see, take a look what time it is. 5:31. What a great time for me to play video games and sit on the computer. So now I went out, I got Wendy's. Wendy's was very, very good. I liked it a lot. Dave's single was pretty decent. I think I'm going to go back to my usual dollar menu order again, though, to be honest. And now, guys, now begins the real grind. Now I get to be on the computer for like the next 12 hours. It's going to be great. Well, it's been a very productive 6.5 hours or 6 hours now. As you can see here, we're making a lot of progress, playing Rust, and I'm on Twitter. So we've had a pretty productive day. It's been great. Haven't really gotten up except for like twice, actually probably a few times. And now I'm going to go throw away some stuff from the old refrigerator. And you know what? I've been working pretty hard today. I think I deserve a reward. I think we're going to go up to Jack in the Box. Get myself a milkshake. Let's go ahead and do that.
Alright. Fingers crossed, gentlemen. We're over here at Jack in the Box now. It's about 12:40 at night. And we're getting ready to see if they've got a milkshake. Now, there's 3 or 4 people ahead of me, which always makes it more annoying if they don't have one. It's one thing if you drive over there and you get fucked in the ass, but if you have to wait for it at the same time, that's a bit much. So we'll see what happens. Anyway, usually this Jack in the Box, each Jack in the Box has like a... Turn this down a bit. Each Jack in the Box has like a probability of milkshake, like a milkshake probability factor. And at past, I'd say like 10 p.m., anything after 10 p.m. is going to be, that's into the free-for-all territory. And I'd say this one is about 70%. The one that I'm going to have to go to after this is only 40. So if this one doesn't have it, and I go here all the time, so this is a large sample size. I want to make sure that's very clear. And we'll see what happens, but I'm... remaining optimistic. Usually if there's this many people in line, they're probably at least working there. There's not like some bullshit going on, but we'll have to see. I don't know, guys. I've been to like every Jack in the Box here in Austin, Texas. I'm gonna be honest, every single one, because I'm the kind of guy, right? It's like, I like staying up late. I feel good at night. So here I'm feeling like I'm feeling 1,000 times better than whenever I woke up. And I've gotta fix my fucking schedule already. Like, it's been like 3 days since I stopped streaming. I'm already staying up until 6 a.m. So we'll see what's gonna happen. Oh, this is always the most awkward thing, is whenever somebody pulls in behind me. And I want to leave in case they don't have what I want. And so it's going to be a real fucking pain in the dick if this happens. But we'll see what happens. I don't know. You know, hopefully they just have it and I don't have to worry about it. But, you know, just fingers crossed. So I was playing some Rust. Good game. So I logged on this morning and I was immediately greeted by a rocket. From another team, Myth's team, and it turned out that, bitch, yeah, he decided to leave. Good, now I don't have to worry about it. Anyway, so, Myth was raiding my base, Myth and Symphony and all those guys, raiding my base again, and, we have an electrician in our little compound, and our electrician brilliantly decided to set up auto turrets, and he put one auto turret directly, like, I guess, like, parallel from my door. So anytime I would walk out the door at all, the auto turret would just insta-kill me. So I was literally getting door camped by my own team's auto turrets for about an hour while they blew up my base. I was not happy. I'll tell you that right now. I was not a happy camper. And I logged off. And then I logged on to Warzone. And I played like shit in Warzone. I logged into WoW and I realized I don't want to play the game right now. I've done basically everything. And went back over to Rust and I started farming trees. You know, it's like one of the things that it always really makes you feel good. And it's like a very relaxing and how long is this going to take? Look, I've been here for 4 minutes. Do they have to slaughter the cow? Do they have to milk the cow? Like, what is this? How long is this going to take? Oh, whatever. It doesn't matter. Realistically, there's not really anything I have better to do than sit in a drive-thru. So anyway, it's always very therapeutic for me to sit around and just mine. Sit around and just cut down trees. And I don't know what it is about it, but the gathering skills, and it was like this in WoW too. Like, I never really got into this that much with WoW, but I did do it sometimes. And what I would do is I would just, anytime I was having a bad day, you know, I got a, you know, bad report card, failed a test, you know, another girl didn't respond to me, even after I said, please respond, twice, called her a bitch. I tried to say something after that, but, you know, it's too late at that point. Anyway, so, yeah, whenever I'm having a bad day, generally, whenever I'm having a bad day, I'd go mining. And it always would make me feel better. It would just be relaxing and just chill. And these games kind of reignited that ability because I have to do that now in these games. Like, I'm really looking forward to New World because New World has that too, and it'll be really fun. Okay, guys, moment of truth. Here we go. No. Could I get... Okay.
Hey, what can I get for you?
Hi, could I get a regular vanilla shake?
You want what?
A regular vanilla shake.
Okay, what else?
That's it.
Okay, hold on.
70%, boys. 70%. It's nice. So yeah, anyway, I forgot what I was talking. Oh yeah, gathering. Yeah, I would love to do gathering and just chill out. I'm looking forward to doing that in New World. And it's always nice to play new games like that because it's always like a... like, nobody really knows what's going on. You have people that played the alpha, people played the beta, but nobody really, really just, like, gets it. And I think, like, the beginning of games like that is always... Oh, this is going to sound a little bit cheesy, but it's always magical. You know, it feels good. Everybody's all in it together. People aren't caring about metagaming. People don't even know what the metagame is. People are just playing the game. And this is the way that gaming used to be for a long time until people's jobs literally revolved around telling you and teaching you the metagame, at which point it changed quite a bit. But those very beginning moments of games in their life cycle, it's always a little bit nostalgic because that's the way that they always used to be. That's the way they always were. And I'm really looking forward to that with Ashes of Creation. Shadowlands to an extent, but I think WoW is like, it's a solved game to a large degree. People kind of know what the parameters are. They know what the factors are, what the probabilities are, what everything is. And so it's not really quite the same thing. Turn around here and get ready for this. There we go. So yeah. Oh, red, huh? Let's turn that down, dude. Actually, I probably don't want to do that. That's his breakaway. Anyway, so yeah, I think at the beginning of games like that, especially like multiplayer, like online games, like Rust, especially MMOs. MMOs, like every MMO is good, except for Bless Online. Every other MMO is good for at least, you know, the first month or so. And that's really all I'm hoping to get out of these other games. I'm looking forward. It's going to be a good month. It's going to be great. And I hope that I can do it more often. I think it's one of the things that excites me about playing the games is developing those storylines. I don't really like role-playing in games. Like, you know, like, oh, howdy there, it's me, Mr. Wizard, and would you like me to make you a portal? Oh, you would, okay. And then, you know, like, you don't actually make a portal because it's fucking Call of Duty or something, right? Like, that type of RP to me, it's just boring. What do you want me to say? It's just boring. But the real roleplay that I love is the fact that everybody, whenever they go online, they act just a little bit different. They act a little bit more more of themselves because they're free to be that person that they are afraid to be in real life. And you lose the barriers of the social mores and social constructs and all of people's trepidations of interaction, and they're just who they are. And I think having that raw interaction is something that makes the internet really addicting. And it's something that makes, I think, online games really addicting too. And it's not just seeing other people in that form, but being in that form yourself. I think that's one of the big factors that nobody really ever talks about, is the fact that whenever you go online, you're just a voice. You could be anybody else, or you're just a player if you're not speaking. So it's a very interesting paradigm, and I think it's probably one of the most interesting things about video games is that it lets people come out of their shell because they don't need to worry about having a shell. They're already protected. It's on the internet. Who gives a shit? So it's one of those really nice things about online games, and whenever I think about it, I romanticize this a lot, and it's because I feel that way. I love it. That's why I romanticize it. I think it's one of the coolest things ever. I remember back in the Halo 2 lobbies, I would always just, like, talk to some guy who's like, oh, yeah, bro, I'm 15. Like, how much you make? Oh, dude, I'm 14. Oh, shit, dude. And, like, man, dude, they're making me do this homework with these fucking... Man, they put letters in the math now. Like, oh, bro, dude, they did that same shit to me last year. And it's like, it feels good. It's like, especially back then, right? Because it was the novelty of it wasn't really as prevalent now as it is now. So it's a really interesting and special experience. And I think more people need to respect it and need to appreciate it. I think it's probably the best thing about online games, if I had to say. It's the same as, like, you know, people always find out, like, I feel like there's more people that have met their girlfriend off of WoW than Tinder. Like, or at least maybe this is just because it's my friend group. But you meet somebody online, and you don't really have to, especially in a video game, right? You don't have to do a whole lot of stuff, you know? It's not like you got to take her out on a first date. You got to worry about, you know, how much money you have or anything like that. It's just the personalities and what's inside, which is supposed to be what counts. Supposed to be. And so, anyway, I've been taking a break from streaming, and I do this pretty regularly, you know, in the grand scheme of things. It's like the third or fourth break that I've taken. And the reason why I take breaks is because I'm a creature of habit. I like doing the same thing all the time. And sometimes I do that too much. And I think that sometimes I need to just kind of break the cycle and do something different. And also, I haven't done laundry in 8 months. For the past 5 months, I've just been going to Target and... buying a new pair of pants about every month and just wearing that until the next month where I'd buy a new pair of pants from Target. So, you know, we're a little bit behind on the real life responsibilities, gentlemen, And why is that? Why am I not a normal person? Oh, I don't know. It could be a million different reasons. It's kind of annoying. I am how I am, but it is what it is. I can't really... I don't know. I can't worry about it too much, and I try to just enjoy myself, and I hate this song. Okay. Yeah, so anyway, I like being who I am, but there's also a lot of annoying parts of it. I'll say that for sure. And one annoying part is you have the you're compelled to go to Jack in the Box. Excuse me. Compelled to go to Jack in the Box at 1 in the morning and wait for about 20 minutes just to get a milkshake, and probably should have got something else. I took all the stuff out of the refrigerator. For some reason, the freezer started working again. I have literally no idea why it started working again. But, I mean, fuck it. If it's going to work again, I'm not even going to take the shit out of it. So, that's pretty much where I'm at now. And got the refrigerator, as I said. It's coming next week. Very happy about that, too. We have on the refrigerator, I've got to post a picture of this on Twitter. We have a little magnet my mom would cut out and print little tiny little pictures of raccoons on them. And remember back in like World War II? We don't remember, right? But remember, you see the movies and you see like the fighter pilots, and they have like little planes on the side of their jet or of their airplane, of how many other things they shot down, how other planes they shot down. Well, we have on the refrigerator little magnets with little raccoons in a cage on them, and they're stacked on top of each other, like, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4. I think we have like 8 or 9 of them. And we would cut out a new one and put a new one up on the refrigerator every single time that we would catch a raccoon in the house. So, I'm going to have to move those over to the new refrigerator. I don't think I can afford to lose that. And they're a little faded now, because I used to... There haven't been any raccoons that have gone into the house for a while, which is, I guess, probably a good thing. All right, here we go. Let's go ahead and get our food. Hi. Just a regular vanilla shake. Oh, for real? Appreciate it, bro. Thank you. Can I get that? Yo, he just, he literally just gave me the shake. Like, he actually just gave me the shake. What the fuck? That's crazy. What's wrong with it? What's wrong with it, man? I don't know what to say. I think it might just be because, you know, they've got so many people in the line and they can just give one guy a shake. I mean, let's be honest, this shit's completely fucking overpriced. I mean, this whole, like $3 for this? Come on. Give me a fucking break. Look at this right here. Yeah, there it is. It's not really all melted all the way there, but, you know. I find that people are usually way more chill at night. If I go somewhere, like if you go somewhere at like 3 p.m., man, these guys act like fucking they've got stock in McDonald's whenever they don't want to give you an extra packet of barbecue sauce. But if you show up at 2 a.m. and you're like, "Hey, bro, like, can I get 3?" They're like, "Yeah, fuck it, dude. Why not?" So it's one of the positives too. Anyway, it's getting dark. I gotta drive home, so I'll talk to you guys later.
Well, I got back home and I had my milkshake. It was really good. It was great, actually. And it's about 1:40 now, and I'm gonna do a little stream on my second channel. Get ready for PoE on Friday. That's gonna be good. And then probably get ready, maybe reward myself for working so hard today, and lay in bed and watch Netflix.
So I'm filming a video today. It's called A Day in the Life of Asmongold. Do you guys want to be part of the video? All right. Say hi, YouTube. I'm recording right now. Say hi, YouTube. There you go, boys. I'll have it recorded tomorrow. It's like 4:45 in the morning. And oh my god, is it fireworks? Wow, look at that. It's crazy. I didn't even know you could do that. Yeah, I'm gonna have a video tomorrow. I made a video, a day in the life of me.
Well, I was gonna record a video right before I fell asleep, but I fell asleep, so I couldn't do it. It was a long day, it was a lot of work, and so I'm just gonna record this one in the morning, and, just kinda go from there. So, thanks a lot for tuning in, watching pretty much what I do on a daily basis, and seeing pretty much how things go around here. I just woke up a little bit ago. It's about 3 or 4 p.m. here, and I'm going to walk down to the store and buy a drink. So, thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.